without Ronaldo, completely different team. Watch Real Madrid, Atletico Madrid over there. Benzema is utter dog shit. The guy, I don't even know, he comes too deep for a starter, and he does pointless stuff. He don't make the runners. There's no ambition for him. It's just Bale stepped up. Bale came in to that Real Madrid Atletico Madrid game, and he actually did dominate. He just ran past players. He's got the athleticism. But shown by Fletcher Cumbridge's first goal. To credit to Diego Costa, he got past. He did dominate that game. Like he's an animal. He's a sick player. Yeah. In the position he was in, no one's gonna take him down. All he from where he was, all he could do was hit the ball hard and high. And Keylor Navas just basically ducked under the ball. For me, that is poor, especially for Real Madrid, which had won Champions League years in a row. But to have a keeper like that, he's proved it that he ain't that good. Even when Costa Rica played England in a friendly, Rashford basically chipped him from like 30 yards out. That's poor from the best team in the world's keeper. So now they've got Courtois, I think that was good.
Bale on a charge, and it goes towards Benzema. Bale the.
To be fair, Atletico Madrid's first half was quite strong, but they also started the second half strong because they were just keeping simple, keeping the ball, played well. And to be fair, Griezmann looked fatigued from World Cup. He shouldn't start that game. I see why he did. He's the best player, but they should have brought him on later. Still, they did dominate the game, to be fair though. But Atletico, Lamar, let's talk about Lamar. The World Cup, watched him, the guy could not string a pass. Proved it again in that game. I mean, there's one incident where he got past like three players, a simple pass, and he just got intercepted. Like, he's young. He's going to be good. He's proved he's going to be good. But to be that next level, I think he needs to simple his game a bit more, to be fair. And then Godin is class. Never really watched, but after watching the World Cup and watching Godin play in Real Madrid, the guy I think is one of the best in the world by far. Then Real Madrid's goal was poor from Juanfran, but unlucky to be fair for the penalty.
Benzema, the finisher! It's Sergio Ramos, and it's calmly done!
For a professional, you should not keep your hand down. You don't stand on it. It's blatant on ball. Then it were a good penalty from Ramos, to be fair. But to be fair, like, Diego Costa probably should have got sent off that year, I'm not gonna lie. He just runs. You don't care at all. He showed it because 10 minutes he's having a laugh with Ramos and that at the back talking and that. 10 minutes later he just ran through, absolutely dominated it. But to be fair, for Atletico Madrid, their second goal they played really well because it was great battling from Juanfran, and then Correa did quick feet, passed it in, and it was very nice. Just to sit, it was put on a plate for Costa. They couldn't miss, but it was good like awareness and play from the whole.
Good determination showed there by Juanfran, and then Correa, and then there's Costa.
And the third goal, it was poor from Real Madrid. Pass it. The best thing, you should be passing it around the back like that. Ramos passed it to Varane, just lost it. Shouldn't be doing that at all. Costa played well to recover the ball, then Thomas Partey, I think that's his name, it was a good cross, like he couldn't do much, just swing into the box and saw Saul. That's a finish, that is a cracking finish. Volley, just powered it.
The pressure from Thomas Partey, who gets it back from Diego Costa. And then, what a finish! No emotion from Simeone. But that's an absolute rocket from Sal Niguez. There's another opportunity and another goal. Well, there's the...
tell on the pitch they were lacking that star man that has aura and atmosphere and weight to his name, which Ronaldo obviously has. But for Athletic Madrid's fourth goal, it was great strength from Costa. He did play really well, to be fair, and he picks his pass, and Vitolo, who were well, good awareness and vision to pass it back to Koke, but he dug to go away from the finish. Koke was good. And then let's just talk about Kevin De Bruyne, injury for Man City. Knee injury out for around 3 to 4 months. Not quite, I don't think he's going to do much. He's their best player, not gonna lie. But he didn't even play against Arsenal in the 1-2-0. And I don't think he played against Chelsea in the Community Shield, and they still won. They still did dominate against two of the best teams in Premier League English football. And for me, not having him for 4 months, it's gonna be a hit, no doubt. But the players they have on top of that, Fernandinho, Gundogan, David Silva, Mahrez, Sterling, Bernardo Silva, they're all world class players. Even Phil Foden, even putting them in a few games, they're gonna score goals and they're gonna play well. Still up there winning the league, but obviously there's other teams like Liverpool and stuff, but you never know, could be an interesting season from this. So if you